Hello everybody, this is Alaa Abdullah speaking. Today we will talk about anti-protozoal drugs. Firstly, we will talk about malaria. Malaria, there are four species of Plasmodium typically cause human malaria: Plasmodium falciparum, Plasmodium vivax, Plasmodium malariae, Plasmodium ovale. A fifth species is Plasmodium newellsi. Is primarily a pathogen of monkeys, but recognized to cause illness including severe disease in human in Asia. Plasmodium falciparum is responsible of serious complication and can lead to disease. Drug resistance is an important therapeutic problem, most notably with Plasmodium falciparum. Drug classifications. Drugs that eliminate developing or dormant liver forms are called tissue schizonticides. Those that can act on erythrocytic parasite are blood schizonticides, and those that kill asexual stages and prevent the transmission to mosquitoes are gametocytes. فعندنا ثلاثة أنواع من drug use for malaria. Schizonticides kill and liver forms, and blood schizonticides that kill erythrocytic parasites, and gametocytes kill and sexual stages and prevent a transmission. No single available agent can reliably effect a radical cure, that is to say, eliminate both allelic and erythrocytic stages. Few agents are causal prophylactic drugs, that is to say, capable of preventing erythrocytic infection. All effective chemoprophylactic agents kill erythrocytic parasite before they increase sufficiently in a number to cause clinical diseases. When patients are counseled on the prevention of malaria, it is imperative to emphasize measures to prevent mosquito bites. For example, with insect repellents, اللي هم ديل المسوح المسحة بتاعت الحر المسحة بتاعت البعوضة. Insecticides and bed nets, because parasites are increasingly resistant to multiple drugs and no chemoprophylactic regimen is fully protective. The first drug used for malaria, the chloroquine, has been a drug of choice for both treatment and chemoprophylaxis since 1940s, but its usefulness against Plasmodium falciparum has been seriously compromised by drug resistance. If it remains a drug of choice for the treatment of sensitive Plasmodium falciparum and other species of human malaria parasites, chloroquine, highly effective blood schizonticide, chloroquine is not reliably active against liver stages parasite or gametocytes. Resistance to chloroquine very common among strains of Plasmodium falciparum and uncommon but increasing for Plasmodium vivax. Clinical use of chloroquine, drug of choice in treatment of uncomplicated non-falciparum and sensitive falciparum malaria, used as prophylaxis, preferred chemoprophylactic agent in malaria regions without resistant falciparum malaria. في الحتات اللي فيها ملاريا بصورة كبيرة لكن ما يكون فيها اللي هو الفالسيبرم resistant. Eradication of Plasmodium vivax and ovale require a course of primaquine to clear even allelic stages of malaria. Number 3, use for amoebic liver abscesses. Chloroquine reaches higher liver concentration and may be used for amoebic abscesses that fail initial therapy with metronidazole. Side effect, pruritus is common, primarily in Africans, nausea, vomiting, abdominal pain, headache, anorexia, malaise, blurring of vision, and urticaria are uncommon. Dosing after meal may reduce some adverse effect. Rare reactions include hemolysis in patients with glucose 6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficient, impaired hearing, confusion, psychosis, seizure, agranulocytosis, exophyllative dermatitis, alopecia, bleaching of hair, hypertension, and electrocardiographic changes. The long-term administration of high doses of chloroquine for a patient with rheumatologic diseases can result in irreversible ototoxicity, can result in retinopathy, can result in myopathy and peripheral neuropathy. Chloroquine contraindicated in patient with psoriasis or patient with porphyria. The second one is amiodarone. Amiodarone is closely related to chloroquine. Share same mechanism of action and share same resistance. Amiodarone was widely used to treat malaria because of its low cost, limited toxicity, and effectiveness against chloroquine resistant strains of Plasmodium falciparum. But the toxicities, including agranulocytosis, aplastic anemia, hepatotoxicity, have limited its use. Then we have the third one is artemisinin and its derivative. Artemisinin is a sesquiterpene lactone endoperoxide, the active component of herbal medicine that has been used as antipyretic in China for more than 2,000 years. And the man of Sunin can be استخدموه to as antipyretic, who عبارة عن herbal medicine, لكن هو عبارة عن شنو sesquiterpene lactone. Artemisinin insoluble can only be used orally. Analog have been synthesized to increase the solubility and improve an anti-malarial efficacy. For example, artocinate, which is water soluble, can be used orally, can be used intravenously, intramuscularly, and can be used for rectal administration. Artemether is lipid soluble, oral, intramuscular, and rectal administration. Dihydroartemisinin is water soluble for oral administration. Oral combination regimen, Quartam Artemether and Lumefantrine, was approved in 2009, first line therapy of for uncomplicated falciparum malaria. Intravenous artocinate is available also. Artemisinin and analogs, their analogs, very rapidly acting. Blood schizonticides, they are blood schizonticides against all human malaria parasites. Artemisinins have no effect on hepatic stages. They are active against young but not mature gematocytes. The anti-malarial activity of artemisinin appear to result from production of free radicals that follows the iron catalyzed cleavage of the artemisinin endoperoxide bridge. Side effects and precautions: artemisinin are generally well tolerated. Most commonly adverse effect: nausea, vomiting, diarrhea, dizziness, and this may often be due to underlying malaria rather than the medication. Rare serious side effects include neutropenia, anemia, hemolysis, elevated liver enzyme, and allergic reactions. Recommended artemisinin-based combination therapy for a treatment of uncomplicated falciparum malaria during the second and third trimester of pregnancy. Quinine plus clindamycin is recommended during the first trimester. And IV artocinate for the treatment of severe malaria during all stages of pregnancy. For during a pregnancy, بنستخدم الارتميسينين كومباينيشن during the second and third, while في الفيرس بنستخدم الكينين plus الكليندامايسين والIV artocinate بنستخدمه for a severe malaria لكل الاستيجيز بتاعت البريجنانسي. بعد في الكينين and كوينيدين, كوينين and كوينيدين remain important therapy for severe falciparum malaria. كينين is derived from park لحابتا tree called Cinchona Park. After oral administration, quinine is rapidly absorbed, reach plasma level in 1 to 3 hours, and is widely distributed in body tissues. The use of a loading dose on severe malaria allow the achievement of big level within a few hours. Antimalarial action of quinine and quinidine. Quinine is a rapid acting, highly effective blood schizonticide against all four species of a human malaria parasite. The drug is germicidal against Plasmodium vivax and ovale, but not all falciparum. The mechanism of action of quinine is unknown. Clinical uses: parenteral treatment for severe falciparum malaria, oral treatment of falciparum malaria, malaria chemo prophylaxis. Babesiosis: quinine is the first line service for babesiosis in combination with clindamycin in the treatment of infection with Babesia microti or other human babesial infections. Side effects of quinine and quinidine. The therapeutic dose of quinine quinidine commonly cause tinnitus, headache, nausea, dizziness, flushing, visual disturbances. All these symptoms are termed as synchronism. جاي من اللي هو السينكونا اللي هو التريا اللي بنطلع منها الكينين والكوينيرين. Severe hypotension can follow two rapid intravenous infusion of quinine and quinidine. عشان كده كينين والكوينيرين بنديهم لما نديهم as infusion بنديهم in slow rate. Electrocardiographic abnormalities, QT interval prolongation with intravenous quinidine. Then we have a mefloquine, effective therapy for many resistant chloroquine strains of Plasmodium falciparum and against other species. Mefloquine is one of the recommended chemoprophylactic drugs for use in most malarial endemic region with chloroquine resistant strains. The antimalarial action resistant to mefloquine has a strong blood schizonticidal activity against falciparum vivax, but is not active against hepatic stages or gametocytes. The mechanism of action is unknown. Mefloquine resistance does not appear to be associated with resistance to chloroquine. Mafi cross resistance. Mefloquine used for chemo prophylaxis. Mefloquine is effective in prophylaxis against kullel strains. Mefloquine used for treatment of uncomplicated falciparum malaria. While a side effect, weekly dosing of mefloquine for chemo prophylaxis may cause nausea, vomiting, dizziness, sleep, and behavioral disturbances, epigastric pain, diarrhea, abdominal pain, headache, rashes, and dizziness can cause neuropsychiatric toxicity. Mefloquine contraindicated in patients with a history of epilepsy, psychiatric disorder, arrhythmia, cardiac conduction defects, or sensitivity-related drugs. Should not be co-administered with quinine or quinidine or halofantrine, and caution is required if quinine or quinidine is used to treat malaria after mefloquine chemo prophylaxis. Then we have a primaquine, drug of choice for eradication of dormant liver forms of vivax and ovale, and can also be used for chemo prophylaxis against all malaria species. The drug is also gametocidal against the four human malaria species and has weak activity against erythrocytic stages parasite, and mechanism of action is unknown. Clinical uses: use as therapy, radical cure of acute vivax and ovale malaria, terminal prophylaxis of ovale and vivax, chemo prophylaxis for malaria, gametocidal action. It can be used for pneumocystis jirovigi infection. The combination of clindamycin, primaquine is an alternative regimen in the treatment of pneumocystosis. This regimen offers improved tolerance compared with high dose trimethoprim, sulfamethoxazole, or bentamidine. Contraindication and caution: primaquine should be avoided in patients with a history of granulocytopenia or methemoglobinemia. In those receiving potential myeloid suppressive drugs, for example, quinidine, and in those with disorders that commonly include myeloid suppression. Contraindicated in patients should be tested for a G6BD deficiency also. Then we have a group of drug inhibitors of folate synthesis. Inhibitors of enzyme involving folate metabolism are used in combination regimens in the treatment and prevention of malaria. For example, pyrimethamine, which is related to trimethoprim, and another example, broguanil, which is biguanide derivative. Broguanil must be administered daily for chemoprophylaxis, whereas pyrimethamine can be given once a week for a chemoprophylaxis. Broguanil, Brodrex, triazine metabolite cycloguanil is the active form. Fancy that, it's fixed combination of sulfonamide, sulfadoxine, 500 mg per tablet, and pyrimethamine. Pyrimethamine anti-malarial action and broguanil act slowly against erythrocytic forms of susceptible strains. Of all four human malaria species, broguanil has activity against hepatic forms. Pyrimethamine and broguanil inhibit albumoxymodial dihydrofolate reductase, which is the key enzyme in pathway for the synthesis of alpha-folate. Sulfonamide and sulfone inhibit another enzyme in the folate pathway, which is dihydroteriate synthase enzyme. Clinical uses of an antifolate: chemoprophylaxis, intermittent preventive therapy, treatment of chloroquine-resistant falciparum malaria, toxoplasmosis, and pneumocytosis. We have some antibiotics used as antimalarial, like tetracycline and doxycycline, active against erythrocytic schizonts of all human malaria parasite. They are not active against liver stages. Doxycycline used treatment of falciparum malaria in conjunction with quinine, allowing shorter and better tolerated course of the drug. Doxycycline used to complete the treatment courses after initial treatment of severe malaria with IV quinine, IV quinidine, or artesunate. A 1 week treatment course of doxycycline is carried out. Then after malaria, we have amoebiasis. Amoebiasis is infection of Entamoeba histolytica. This organism can cause asymptomatic intestinal infection, can cause mild to moderate colitis, can cause severe intestinal infection with cold dysentery, amoeba, liver abscess, and other extra-intestinal infection. The choice of drug for amoebiasis depends on the clinical presentation. Treatment of a specific form of amoebiasis: number one, an asymptomatic intestinal infection, asymptomatic carriers not treated in endemic area. But in non-endemic area, they are treated with aluminal amoebicide. A tissue amoebicidal drug is unnecessary for asymptomatic infection. Standard luminal amoebicide are diloxonide ferroate, iodoquinone, and paraomycin. Each drug eradicate a carriage in about 80-90% of patients. Therapy with aluminal amoebicide is also required in the treatment of all other forms of amoebiasis. The second one is amoebic colitis. Metronidazole plus luminal amoebicide is the treatment of choice for an amoebic colitis and dysentery. Tetracycline and azithromycin are alternative for moderate colitis, but are not effective against extra-intestinal disease. Treatment of extra-intestinal infection: metronidazole plus also luminal amoebicide, 10-day course of metronidazole. Over 95% of uncomplicated liver abscesses can be cured. For unusual cases in which initial therapy with metronidazole has failed, aspiration of the abscess and the addition of chloroquine to a repeat course of metronidazole should be considered. metronidazole and tinidazole. The nitro group of metronidazole is chemically reduced in anaerobic bacteria and sensitive protozoans. Reactive reduction products appear to be responsible for an antiprotozoal and an antibacterial activity. Mechanism of tinidazole is assumed to be the same as a metronidazole. Metronidazole used for amoebiasis, giardiasis, and trichomoniasis. Then we have another one is diloxynite furoate. Is effective luminal amoebicide but is not active against trophozoites. In the gut, diloxynite furoate split into diloxynite and furoic acid. 90% of a diloxynite is rapidly absorbed and then conjugated to form the glucuronide, which is promptly excreted in the urine. The unabsorbed diloxynite is the active anti-amoebic substance. Mana 10% here, you know, here active. Then we have a paraomycin sulfate, a minor glycoside antibiotic, not significantly absorbed from a GIT, used as luminal amoebicide, no effect against Elkistra intestinal organism, and ما بيحصل له absorption. And then other antiprotozoal drugs, for example, pentamidine, this administered intravenously, can also be inhaled as a nebulized powder for the prevention of pneumocytosis. The mechanism of action of pentamidine unknown. Clinical use, pentamidine used for a pneumocytosis, pentamidine used for an African trypanosomiasis, a whole sleeping sickness, more than norm. Pentamidine has been used since 1940 and is the drug of choice to treat an early hemolymphatic stage of disease caused by trypanosoma brucei gambiens. Pentamidine used for leishmaniasis. Then lastly, we have sodium stibuprofloxacin, pentavalent antimonials, including sodium stibuprofloxacin and meglumine antimoniate. They are first line agent for cutaneous and visceral leishmaniasis. The drugs are rapidly absorbed and distributed after intravenous or intramuscular administration. Treatment is given at a dose of 20 mg per kg once daily, intravenously or intramuscularly for 20 days in cutaneous leishmaniasis and 28 days for visceral and mucocutaneous disease. And mechanism of action of antimonials, اللي هم سواء كان الاستيبوجلوكونيت أو الميجلومين unknown. Thank you very much for your attention.